All eyes are on the LA Rams this week as the Green Bay Packers are in town and Coach Mike McCarthy is getting ready to take on his former team. It's also a matchup between the top two teams in the NFC, so it might be a better reason to watch the game for that. But regardless, we should be in for quite a show. Aaron Rodgers has led the Packers to a pretty good start to the year. They're 8-2 right now, and they're one of the top teams in the league, but they're also one of the more consistent teams. While the Rams have been pretty good in some games with certain situations, but sometimes we just can't stay consistent enough. And that's led to one loss this year and a couple of really close calls, but the Rams get the ball to begin this game and up the middle once again and just can't find anywhere to go on these kick returns. Still a good return up to the 28-yard line. It's still one of the better returners in the league, but just not seeing a lot of great blocking downfield. First and 10, and a give to Todd Gurley, able to find 2 yards on first down. That's a lot better than we've seen the past couple of weeks where he's getting shut down immediately. But the ground game's been one of the big issues for the Rams. We've been trying to get the ground game going, maybe putting a little too much trust into it as Gurley crosses the 40. That's good enough for a first down, but a flag will bring this one back. That is holding on Greg Robinson. So now we're looking at second and 18 from the 20. Goff looking to throw, throws right side for Jason Witten up to the 28-yard line. So back where we started, but now it's 3rd and 10. Goff from the shotgun looking to throw, has time to find me across the middle for a first down, moving the chains up to the 43. That's a nice throw right there. Ball at the 49-yard line, 2nd and 5. Going back to Todd Gurley, trying to get around the edge, and Gurley able to find a first down, cuts up the middle. And that's going to get us to the 46-yard line. So 2 carries for Gurley, 7 yards, still around the same average. Going play action on first down. This is Goff throwing down the seam for Kenny Britt. First down at the 25-yard line. Goff with time to throw. Would have liked to see him put this a little more to the left for, you know, Britt to really run with it after he caught the ball because there was a lot of room there. But Kenny Britt, good catch, good first down. And the Rams nearing the red zone. It's 1st and 10. Going play action once again. Goff will dump this one off to the right side, and that is going out of bounds. And that'll give us a chance to look at the Packers defense. We're playing another really good defense this week, and we're going to keep playing defenses that are really good for the next couple of weeks. But Green Bay's front seven is pretty solid. Clay Matthews, as always, is a problem. Nick Perry, they've got Ha Ha Clinton Dix, Morgan Burnett, Sam Shields, and Demaryius Randall. Nothing really to scoff at. They're a pretty good overall team. Goff taking a shot downfield one-on-one, and I can't haul it in. We're seeing a lot more jump balls thrown my way this year with the practice we've been putting in. But 3rd and 10, Goff throws my way. That is going to be a first down for the Rams. Crossing the 15 down to the 13. That'll move the chains again. 2nd down and 10, lining up in the slot and going back to the ground game. Gurley spinning upfield inside the 10 down to the 8-yard line. Solid gain, good for 5. Now it's 3rd and 4. And the Rams have had some issues in the red zone this year, especially inside the 10. And we just put too much faith in the run game sometimes. This has been an issue for us. We just think, you know what, it's a 3rd down situation. We got this side stacked. They shouldn't be able to stop the run. And every single time, we get proven wrong. And I'm trying to remind Coach, hey, you've got 2 of the best receivers in the league on the outside, 3rd and 4. The ground game's not working. Let's throw it. But at least we got the field goal. So back on the field, still in the first quarter in Green Bay territory. Dodrick Buggs, the first overall pick for the Rams this year, has been an interception master picking off Aaron Rodgers. We get the ball back in their territory. And I'm a little annoyed there that Goff threw that ball so far before I had to dive out for it. But 3rd and 2, Rams trusting the ground game. Can Todd Gurley get it? Again, it's 3rd down and we get stopped. So we settle for another field goal. Back on the field, this time the Packers are actually going to back us up inside our own territory at our 16-yard line, but still, we got to find a way to get in the end zone. 1st and 10, Goff throwing across the middle. This is complete to Gage Carver. That's good for 14 yards up to the 30-yard line. Now it's 2nd and 7. Rams going to the ground game again. Can we trust Todd Gurley? And he actually finds 3 yards this time. So now it's 3rd down and 5, but we got to actually throw the ball this time around. We know we can't run it, and that's a quick pass out to Gage Carver. Carver up the sideline, already passing midfield, and Carver down to the Green Bay 20. Already 100 yards for Jared Goff through the air, and Gage Carver, man-on-man, Ha Ha Clinton Dix did not have a chance here. There's just too much speed, too much talent on this receiving core for them to be trying to line up man-to-man. But Gage Carver, I really wish he would just stay towards the left sideline. He kind of ran into Burnett there, but still a really good play call there to get us inside the red zone again. But this time, can we add a touchdown? 1st and 10, Goff to the air. He will throw, and this one is caught in the end zone for the touchdown. And there it goes, the score we needed. There it goes, receiving touchdown number 10 on the year. It's been a slow start, but finally getting up to double digits like we knew I could. And another jump ball downfield, this time winning it. And that's a snag. That's one-handed right there. That's a beautiful catch. And getting both feet in bounds. That's a pretty hard thing to do. And I'm going to walk to the sideline after the play and tell Coach, hey, thank you for putting your faith in me. But look at what Jared Goff did. He rolled out and threw it on the run. He is so lucky this wasn't picked off. He is so lucky. But that's actually a really nice play there. Goff trusting the receiver downfield. And let me go up there and get the catch. So that would take us to the second quarter, still up by 13. And the Rams at the 22-yard line, going Wildcat right side, showing off the speed. We've been using this play a lot, and it's been pretty efficient. Yeah, that'll get us down to the 36-yard line, good for 14 yards. Five wide set for the Rams. Goff from the gun. We'll try to set up a screen. Goff instead will roll out to his left and fire for Kenny Britt. What is going on with Jared Goff today? Throwing on the run has not been his strong suit this year. He actually makes a lot of mistakes throwing on the run, but this is impressive. Rolls out to his left, feels the pressure coming from Clay Matthews, finds Kenny Britt with some accuracy, and after the play, he's pointing to the other receivers like, yo, I got you guys, we're coming at you next, pay attention, we got this win. I honestly don't know where this confidence is coming from, but I'm enjoying it a lot this ball game. Second and nine, and going back to the ground game, and Gurley losing two, and if it's not the offensive line, is Todd Gurley making some kind of mistake? You're running into the defense instead of running through the lane your offensive line opened for you. Sometimes I really feel like I just need to put myself in at Wildcat and just have that be the run offense for this team. Third and 12, Goff firing downfield, and this one goes incomplete. Clinton Dix able to knock that one away. That'll bring up fourth and 12. And back on the field in the second quarter, and the Packers are finally on the board. 6-point ball game. 109 left in the second quarter. Got to find something here on third and nine. Goff looking my way. That is caught near the sideline. And that is ruled not in bounds. Look like a catch to me. I'm talking to Coach on the sideline like, hey, that red flag in your back pocket, you need to throw that. That was a first down catch. But no flag was thrown. That'll take us into the second half. 13-10 ball game in the third quarter. Rams trying to get the ground game going. This is Ty Gurley starting from the Green Bay 35-yard line as Gurley inside the 5 and down to the Green Bay 2. Aaron Rodgers threw another pick. This time, I believe it was Alec Ogletree with the INT, and Ty Gurley with his biggest carry in probably 3 or 4 weeks. That's good for 33 yards and almost got into the end zone. That stiff arm was unneeded. Just plow through him and get into the end zone. First and goal from the 2-yard line is Goff under center. Carver, the man in motion. Goff looking to throw. This is a weird play call by the Rams, and Goff ends up getting sacked. You got to just get rid of the football if no one's open like they weren't. This is unbelievable, and it doesn't help that the offensive line just got run through like a knife through hot butter. Third and goal for the Rams from the 9-yard line, needing a score. This is Goff looking, throwing to the outside for Lance Kendricks, and down to the 3, and we'll settle for 3 once again. So we had a field goal. Green Bay has a field goal. It's a 13-16 ball game, and not a lot of time left in the third quarter, and the ground game is just not there. I mean, it's a little better than it was last week in the weeks before, but still, it's just not what we've been used to. Second down and 9. This is a jet sweep to the left side around the edge and finding a first down, trying to spin past Clinton Dix. Can't get past him. 13-yard gain, though. Is this really the only way that we can efficiently run the ball? First and 10, 40 seconds left in the third quarter, and going stretch outside to Ty Gurley, able to break away from one, and Gurley actually finds a solid gain that time, good for 9 yards. Just second and 1, and we got one more play probably left in the third quarter. This is Ty Gurley up the middle and finally seeing some production up the middle of the defense. The offensive line, good job blocking, and a good job there by Harkey leading the way for Ty Gurley, who gets us into Green Bay territory. Third and 8, though, and Goff will throw this one downfield. He's got Gage Carver with the catch inside the 15 and down to the Green Bay 10. Sam Shields is just too small, too slow for Gage Carver, and this should have been a touchdown, but Goff just didn't put enough on this throw. That should have been a touchdown easily. Burnett out of position. Sam Shields got beat. Now it's first and 10, and going back to Ty Gurley trying to get around the edge, and Gurley can't find room to run again. He's brought down the backfield, another 2-yard loss. Rams go 5 wide once again, but a screen set up this time for Gage Carver to the outside. Carver down to the 5-yard line. It's 3rd and 5 for the Rams again in the red zone, and we're definitely not running it this time. Moving in motion across the middle, Goff taking time to throw, has all day and will finally throw it my way, but throws it behind me. I have to fall to the ground, and we're a yard shy of the first down marker. I ran left, I had to turn around and run back to the middle, and yeah, that pass was thrown a little bit too far behind, but that will set us up for a field goal try. But Green Bay drives down the field, they had a touchdown, and they lead for the first time today. Quick throw from Goff to Lance Kendricks, good for 5 yards. Goff being pretty efficient, but we're also playing it pretty safe. Second and 5, Goff time to throw once again, and over the middle, wide open. That beats cover 2, and that's a first down for the Rams. 7 catches on the game, 84 yards and a touchdown, and I might need one more here in the fourth quarter. First and 10, Goff time to throw out to the flat for Jason Witten, who I've actually appreciated kind of stepping up these past couple weeks. He's been getting a lot of receptions, picking up yards, breaking tackles, being a really good blocker for us. Now it's 2nd and 3 from the 42, and this is Todd Gurley losing yardage. That'll back us up to 3rd and 5. As it's Goff from the pistol, 4 wide set, Goff time to throw. He's got Cabrera wide open underneath, but throws it out of bounds, and then brings a 4th down. You've got to be kidding me. Goff, you either throw it or you run it. Britt covered, I'm covered, Cabrera wide open, Carver covered, and Goff just throws it out of bounds. And then our defense can't give us the ball back, so we end up losing in week 12 to the Green Bay Packers, 20-19. This was a winnable game, but Goff kind of just gave up. And that'll definitely be one of the headlines in the sports sections for tomorrow's LA Times. Jared Goff is a quitter? Question mark. Question mark. Maybe another one. Maybe 3 question marks in that article. But again, the Rams having a slow second half. This has been an issue for us pretty much all year. We get off to really good starts. We get a little too complacent, a little too comfortable, and we start falling apart. But good note is that Todd Gurley had one of the best games he's had since probably the halfway point of this season. Jared Goff threw the ball quite a bit this game, found his 2 favorite receivers, and we picked up some good yardage, but unfortunately just wasn't enough, even with Aaron Rodgers turning the ball over twice this game. But one thing they did have going for them was their ground game. Eddie Lacy, 23 carries, 90 yards, and Randall Cobb, 9 receptions, 100 yards, and a touchdown. I mean, he was a big impact for them this game. Jordy Nelson, not so much. We win the turnover battle, but we don't win the game. That's kind of a rare thing for us. But 3rd downs, 4 of 11. Got to do better. Week 13 is here. The Rams are back at home again, and we're taking on the 3-8 Minnesota Vikings. And there's a new number one team in the NFL. That is the Pittsburgh Steelers, followed by the Packers. And the Rams have dropped back to number 3. 9-2, still leading the division. Seahawks still winning games. They're right behind us by a game. And here's a look at the Minnesota Vikings, who might have a better defense than the Green Bay Packers. We just see this happening week after week. Haven't done an attribute update in quite some time. I'm not touching speed, acceleration, or agility for the rest of this career, most likely, unless I start regressing, which shouldn't be happening for another couple of seasons. But I don't want to get to a point where speed is broken and I'm just constantly beating people downfield. But one thing I will spend XP on is upgrading my spin and my juke move. Got to break free on a lot of these kick returns and punt returns, and spinning off of people might be one way to get that done. So that, guys, will do it for week 12. The Rams are right now 9-2, still in a good spot. We're still in a good place for the postseason, but we got a lot of time left. We got the Broncos after this game against the Vikings, and gotta hope that we can pull something off against the Minnesota Vikings and hopefully have the ground game be an impact for this week. But that, guys, will do it for the video. Hope you enjoyed. Make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you all next time. Have a nice day.